A federal lawsuit, inmates committing suicide and scathing accusations of mismanagement and civil rights violations. It's no secret, Erie County jails are under close scrutiny right now. So, is it appropriate to give the man in charge a pay raise? Good evening once again, topping Eyewitness News tonight. Despite recent management issues, the county legislature now being asked to give Sheriff Tim Howard's jail superintendent a pay hike.
It's a 10% raise, bumping the salary of the jail's top cop to more than $100,000 a year. Tonight, critics calling it irresponsible. Channel 7's John Borsa tracking the latest developments on the story tonight. He joins us live from outside the Erie County Holding Center with more.
Good evening. Among those, Joanna, the Erie County Comptroller, who is blasting the sheriff tonight for proposing this pay increase. There have been two successful suicides at the jail recently, a number of attempts, and prisoner escapes, including one that happened just last fall. The Erie County Sheriff Tim Howard tonight asking the county legislature to create a new position for the superintendent of the downtown holding center and the county correctional facility in Alden and increase the pay for that job from the current $95,000 per year to almost $105,000. The department defends the pay hike while critics say the raise rewards bad behavior.
Unfortunately, the sheriff's department for the last few years has been acting with an incompetent level that a lot of us are wondering, why would you reward people at this point? We have the federal government, we have the state government after us. Federal government has a major lawsuit. We need to ensure that we're stopping suicides in the jails, not giving raises to sheriff level appointees.
There's not any additional money required for this, and it's the sheriff's belief that the title of superintendent and the salary that comes with that civil service title is appropriate for the responsibilities that the individual has.
The sheriff's office says this pay hike will not cost taxpayers a dime because the department is lowering the salary of one vacant position and transferring that money to the newly created superintendent's position. Right now, a man by the name of Robert Koch holds the title of First Deputy Superintendent, but he shares that title with two others, and he is considered in charge of the two jail facilities. That's why this new position is being created. Lawmakers in the county legislature are expected to vote on this proposed pay hike at its meeting on Thursday. We're live downtown tonight. John Borsa, Channel 7, Eyewitness News.